Ladies and gentlemen, this is Maddie P.S. Scrumptious, and you're watching New Era Blockbuster. Tony Morales, and I am joined by my esteemed colleague, Crazy Nate Taves.
All right, and I gotta say, happy anniversary, everybody. Happy anniversary to us, but big happy anniversary to New Era Wrestling. And what a way to start out our show.
We have Logan, the 10 out of 10.
Yes, and he's taking on Austin Riddick. And I am not really sure how Logan Austin's direction is going in this match. Since he's teamed with Mac Battle, it's been a little off. They haven't seemed on the same page, especially after their loss of the tag team titles.
Well, let's head on down to the ring and let's check out the action.
Get in the goddamn ring!
This production. We're alive!
The production is, you're supposed to go in, welcome everyone.
Like Harlem in 1997, brother!
Yes, the music was his cue. He didn't understand that the music was his cue to get the fuck in there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to New Era Pro Wrestling 11th anniversary.
Lost one member of the family. So, in doing so, Christ.
I want to have a moment of silence and a 10 bell salute for Josh Trajan Ender Powell. Thank you. Now, I know some of you are hot in here, but not as hot as this show's gonna be. We've got some good matches, and we've got a great crowd. So let's make this 11th awesome, and wait for the 12th.
Are you guys ready for some wrestling?
The last bar fighter against 10 out of 10, what a way to start.
start Nuera's 11th anniversary show.
And while that is impressive, even more impressive, we have the Big New Mag battle with us.
And we started with the bar fighter, the last bar fighter out of Texas himself, Austin Reddick. 10 out of 10 out of 10. Logan.
Right, just recovering from losing his tag team title, Master Reddick.
The reason I'm out here ringside is so we can let Logan do his thing. No questions asked.
Is that what you want out of him?
I think it's good in this little break in the middle. Let's let Logan do his thing.
Is that what you want out of him? Little question?
He's going to do one. He doesn't give
you
one.
How unforgiving was that?
Oh!
the last bar fighter.
You see why there's not one left, that's for sure.
That's true, Logan Austin has blocked into the wrong bar in this ring. But he really needs to hold this up together.
That bar is cool, Jeff. 21.
Wow, that European uppercut just almost knocked him into Europe.
Right now's his bedtime.
Come on, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Now Reddick's just torturing Logan Austin.
It's smart for him to cut off the airways, right? If you're going to do the high-flying moves, so why do that, you know, upper aerial action?
He can't possibly, he can't fight, he can't fly, he can't run.
Shuts you down entirely.
You're sitting up.
Now Reddick's just torturing Logan Austin. And this is what is dangerous. He has an opening. He is going to exploit it. Breaking him down and turning around and trying to
put the boots on.
Trying to intimidate referee Skyler there. But hopefully bought himself enough time with that offense.
Right, certainly heard.
And
this is why you cannot give Austin Reddick a
second.
Oh, wow. You gotta put him on the mat and he wants to misfind it a little bit.
What is this about to be? Crazy. Neither was involved in this game.
Down. Chops, knees.
He needed to execute that a little bit better. Redick able to move his neck around to avoid the full impact of that pell driver.
Okay, I think he used it, his weight advantage to push Logan back a little bit.
It's a better move, that's right. Logan's got the advantage right now as he descends once more.
He's going for it.
If he hits, Redick's not kicking out.
Now tonight, Nate, we've got a one-on-one match between former tag team partners. We have the War Dog, Damian Payne, one half of our current Colorado Tag Team Champions, taking on the natural athlete, Jason Knoll.
Man, I am excited for this match. These two have had an incredible history together. War Dog, and he has been going on a big streak here since he's become tag team champion with Eric Angel, Black Ops. But how is he going to fare against Jason Knoll? I mean, Jason Knoll, he has been working really hard, especially after he's lost that championship.
That's right. We've got a veteran of war taking on a veteran of the ring. Speaking of which, let's head on down there.
Yeah,
off the court.
We have no capitalized working over the head of his
smaller opponent. He is the longest reigning heavyweight champion in the history of New Era, and he's been finding himself in a bit of a slump as of late. Or it should be. Oh, we got some old school Damian coming here.
That is old school. Oh! Something new to the play. We put that film from Black Hawk down. Turns into a fly Hurricane Rana.
All right, Jason Owens definitely disoriented.
Oh, no!
Everyone's legs are within confidence right now.
Midsection of Jason Hall. Lifting his large opponent up to the top turnbuckle. Neither one of these men are known for going to the top rope. Let me see what happens.
Two.
Three. Jason!
Come on, get
up. Two. Oh, no reverses. Another punch is signed by the
head. Cliffhanger battle right here.
Oh!
Exotic Panther, Tyra Rusume, taking on the Gem of the Bay, Jules.
And both of these two have been having an incredible streak here in New Era Wrestling, really representing women's wrestling here in New Era, incredibly so. And Jules has been having an incredible winning streak so far. Will Tyra overcome this? And she's had quite the battles here.
Let's head on down to the ring. Check out the action.
All right.
Thank you. Ring the bell.
Okay.
Let me ask you something, Dave. Why does Taylor Swift not sell fans? She would make a killing.
You got my face. Last time. This time. I'm coming for you.
Let's see if the abdominal stretch is Jules. So, remember that midsection,
Oh, now pulling on the hair.
Watch the hair.
Lisa Rec was paying attention for this one.
Tyra, we connected that headbutt though. Moves the person into a pin. And Tyra with the kick out. Jules with a last stitch punch in the face. Apparently it was enough to keep Tyra up there. Now working off the arm.
Oh wow, just
going right back to that midsection is Jules.
She'll distract you with one, then go back to the task at hand, focusing on that ribs and back.
Again, doing whatever she needs to do to win.
Still, now just back to work on that midsection and punishing it.
Joel's showing ring IQ beyond her years, constantly going back to the midsection.
Wondering if Tyra owes Joel money or something. That's a back to the submission.
Going to that abdominal stretch one more time.
What do you say, Josh?
I think she's tapping.
She's just got to sink in. Tyra's in a lot of trouble.
She keeps going back to the midsection. It's only a matter of time. Tyra's either going to break out of it or recover. Two count by Tyra, reversing it out of Jules. She's going to piss Tyra off, and that is the last thing she's going to want to do.
Elbows all around.
Go again! Go! Oh, big senton!
Does she have it?
Alan Jones finds the will to kick out.
How vicious is Tyra right now?
She is mad.
Now she's just playing how she's really going to hurt.
You see that shaking fist? She is trying to control herself, and she is not doing a very good job of it. She lets loose with full fury. Jules might be in big trouble.
Oh man. Jules trying to get
and a kick to the side of the head of Jules.
Oh, what a vicious moment. Kick. Such innovation. Man. Now Jules knocked outside of the ring.
Tired of all around them. Jules is gonna have to create some distance.
She's gonna have to try to hold face together.
Oh, looks like she might have. Oh, but she didn't lose a tooth.
Or memory, or.
Oh!
Fine.
She comes back with a vicious. Oh, both these men were vicious for him.
Oh, what is she doing?
She's trying to fix the crowd's shoes. She's putting the ring together.
We left the ring crew to do that.
Wait.
In the illustrious 11-year history of New Era Wrestling, we have a verdict being read by a judge.
Yeah, this is very, really unprecedented to have an actual licensing trial here at New Era Wrestling with Dr. Silver. This doesn't set well. Dr. Silver is a dangerous individual. Now, we've heard that he's gonna be in shackles and he's gonna be escorted by security. There's a judge, there's a podium for God's sakes, but I really, really feel, this doesn't sit well with me. I think someone's getting hurt.
Cut.
Fans have said a bit of a quack. All right. I'd say give me a quack, yeah, but move on. Okay. All right, and now for something I never thought I would say during my career as a professional wrestling announcer. Who's ready for a trial? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the verdict of the trial of the Colorado Board of Psychiatry in the state of Colorado versus Dr. Silver. Please welcome the prosecuting attorney, Mr. Nathan Carlisle. And now, the defendant, Dr. Silver.
Thank you.
Honorable Judge Cram.
Dr. Silva, guilty! eating chili, while doing this, there is a chili stain. Also, it looks like it's been done. The duo must have been all inbred wrestling fans, like all of you. So we cannot accept this. We cannot accept this. I'm sorry.
After all the lawyering, after all the work that was done, what are we even looking for?
Guns.
man. Paralysis is bleeding. We need something medical. Oh, boy.
Yep. Get me the fuck out of here, please.
I don't know what I just noticed.
Nate, you don't have to do this, man.
I need to do this. One, Tony wouldn't wanted me to do this. Okay. It's definitely been weird having Tony Morales as my commentator, but it's worked out so well. But we had a trial, and I said someone was gonna get hurt. I said someone was going to get hurt. Dr. Silver is dangerous. Even though he spent time in jail, he somehow orchestrated for somebody to get hurt in the middle of the ring. There was no judge. This whole thing was a sham. This wasn't a meeting. He just did that to beat up a lawyer in the middle of New Era Wrestling. How does that happen? How do you orchestrate that? For God's sakes. And now I had to see him taken away to the hospital. I mean, the amount of blood that was in the ring. I was cleaning that, for crying out loud.
We still haven't heard if Tony's okay, man. You don't have to, I mean, he's gonna be fine.
Look, Tony, when you can come back, please come back. But what is this with Dr. Silver? How does he get away with it?
Hey, man, it's going to be okay. Thank you.